Tomorrow at 10 o'clock, Angel Oak is hosting a webinar starring Barry Habib and Frank Ray, and they're going to teach you how to get into real estate offices, talk with those agents, make them your agent so you could become more successful. Frank Ray and Barry Habib have been doing this stuff a long time. They can help you. You might want to check it out. All you have to do is click this banner right over there. Remember, it's tomorrow at 10 o'clock. Hey, and if this is Facebook, it's right up above. So the CFPB once again lost a court case. Now, if this was baseball, one might say the CFPB is in something of a slump. They're putting up an offer as of late. It's beginning to appear that the courts don't agree with the CFPB's interpretation of RESPA, amongst other things. So, what's this one all about?
From the bluegrass state of Kentucky, in the case of the CFPB versus Borders and Borders, the CFPB asserted that Borders paid kickbacks to the principals of real estate and mortgage brokerage companies that were disguised as profit distributions from the joint ventures, and that the kickbacks were for the referral of customers to Borders by the principal.
So what does that all mean? Well, it means that a settlement service provider, like an escrow company in some states, in Kentucky, you get a lawyer. The CFPB claims they were paying kickbacks to realtors and lenders for those leads.
The courts, however, ruled that Borders and Borders met their safe harbor obligations, which means this is not a RESPA kickback violation. Those safe harbor obligations are joint ventures that each had an operating agreement, were authorized to conduct business in Kentucky, and were approved by a title insurer to issue the title insurance policies.
So now the CFPB, they can appeal this case, and they may do that. But now that we all know that it's just a matter of time before Mr. Cordroy quits and runs for governor of Ohio, one would think that the current administration's future candidate for CFPB director would probably drop this case.
As far as Director Cordroy leaving, we need to think of this. If Cordroy quits tomorrow, we have an acting head of the CFPB that already works at the CFPB. That means the acting director's views would probably fall in line with Cordroy's. Congress is going to have to approve the new Trump-appointed director. Now ask yourself this. Do you think Congress is going to approve a Trump-appointed director? My thinking is probably not, meaning real estate lenders still have to be vigilant with the vendors that they work with and the nature of your relationships.
And it's worth pointing out that CFPB cases are significantly down right now, and that probably has a lot to do with the current court cases the CFPB is currently entangled in. Nevertheless, you don't want to find yourself in these guys' crosshairs, so stay vigilant.
Wells Fargo! We wish we had $10 for every time we said Wells Fargo on this show. Here we go again! Wells Fargo just leaked information on 50,000 account holders. If ever a company was the proverbial red-headed stepchild of lending and banking, it's Wells Fargo. Okay, so what did they do now?
I don't know.
Alright guys, Wells Fargo is being sued, go figure, by a past employee. His attorney requested information from Wells Fargo. And in that information, Wells Fargo attorneys attached information on 50,000 people that included your social security numbers, your names, your addresses, your telephone numbers, and your account numbers, and other personal identifying information. I mean, seriously, how is this possible? What level of ineptitude do you have to reach to accidentally do something like this? Seriously, I'm starting to change my opinion on Wells Fargo. I mean, how do you hire someone that's capable of making this mistake?
I don't know.
Well, Wells, we keep saying that you need to quit getting sued, and you keep doing stupid like this. Oh. If you have a Wells Fargo account, or your clients have a Wells Fargo account, you might want to send a message saying something like, Wells Fargo accidentally released information on 50,000 people. If you have a Wells Fargo account, you might want to contact them to see if you have been compromised, and then always follow up by asking for a referral.
Finally, from recently released records and reported in the New York Times, it appears that the Treasury knew Fannie and Freddie were going to become profitable post-bailout. And that was the reason that they changed the terms of conservatorship.
You may recall, there was a time when the Treasury was getting a 10% return on their investment. But once the Treasury figured out that Fannie and Freddie were going to turn into the most profitable companies in the history of the world, and that's a true statement, by the way, combined, they made more money than anybody over the past 5 years or so. Once they figured that out, the Treasury decided that they would just take all of the money. So yes, my friends, it was greed, not protecting taxpayers, that motivated the Treasury to change the terms of the GSE conservatorship. Say it isn't so. My God, we have been telling you this for years, and now we actually have it in writing.
All right, you guys have a great day. Forward, share, subscribe, leave us your comments down below. We'll catch you later here at the National Real Estate Post.
Share this.
Yeah.
Tag this. And then put a stipply up there of you.
Stipply? You don't know what that is?
Well, you need to see the webinar that we did on yesterday.
Yesterday.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Check that out. You can find it in Mortgage Shots Kills. It'd be a great way for you guys to pick up more business. And it's totally free. Stipply. Later.
Look into it. See you. Bye.
Bye.
Hey, got a permit for those guns?
I've got your permit right here.
Permit denied.
Some